People are often eager to tell you what success looks like. What education, what experiences, what networking and resources you need in your pursuit of happiness. But this is my deepest prayer for you. May you learn to harness your energies toward your passion. May you remember that true strength is found in gentleness. May you keep your word, even when it's hard. May you find the good in yourself and see the good in others. May you keep in mind that everyone is fighting their own battle, and the greatest gift you can give is a kind word. May you fight the urge to be in a hurry, knowing that time is a non-renewable resource. May you find ways to bring peace into your relationships. May you know and experience the fullness of joy. May you feel, know, and share love with everyone, because without it, life is just noise. These are your credentials. This is how you are known. Let these traits be your calling card. May the seeds you've planted continue to bear fruit for endless seasons ahead.
Well, good evening.
Good evening.
Whoa, it's really all right. Good evening.
Good evening.
Wow. Well, it's great to have you, and seniors, congratulations. Thank you for being here. Already, I think we have 20 viewers online, so we want to welcome our families and friends online as well who are watching the live stream. This is a big deal. It was funny, just before the ceremony, somebody was talking to me and said, I didn't even know what the word baccalaureate meant. He raises his hand back there, the bass player. The bass players don't know a lot. No, just teasing. But tradition is, baccalaureate is an opportunity where the community comes together, traditionally the faith community, and it marks a change in life, in a season of life, and it's an opportunity for us here as a community to, if you will, bless you, to pray for you, to honor you in the accomplishments in getting this far and launching you into the next adventure of life. That's a baccalaureate. And it's something that's just, we've had so much fun doing this for the last several years. I am a father of an alumni, Coquille High alumni from 2015. That was my first opportunity to help plan a baccalaureate. And if there's one thing I knew those several years ago, 6 years ago, is this is one event I want to stay deeply connected with. I love to serve our students, the staff, and their families, and you've just done an amazing job. I want to announce, many of you probably already know because you were at the awards last night, but for those who didn't know, this year's class was awarded over $460,000 in scholarships. Yeah, come on, let's give it up. Yeah. Great job, amazing job. And so here's what we're going to do. We're going to ask, we're not going to embarrass you, but if you could just stand right where you're at, seniors, Coquille High, Winter Lakes, homeschool seniors, could you just stand right where you're at and remain standing? Yeah. All right. Yeah, come on. Love it. That's awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Remain standing. Listen, if the whole purpose of us being together is to just honor you and bless you, I want to begin by praying a blessing over you. Can we do that? Let's pray together. God, thank you for these seniors and these young men and women and their accomplishments and all that they've done this year and over the coming years. God, I just pray a blessing over each one. What a tremendous year with all of its challenges, yet here they are. They've persevered. And so, God, we just take opportunity to honor them, to bless them, that you would just speak to them even now, tonight, and for the coming days, and that, God, you would just help them as they discover the next season of their life. God, we love you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Let's applaud the seniors again. Yeah. Good. All right. Well, now you're sitting down, and we're going to ask everybody to stand up. Is that okay? Listen, if you're going to eat all the cheesecake we bought, you're going to have to work out for it a little bit, okay? Because every year when we plan this, every year the seniors say they get to choose their reception dessert, and every year they choose cheesecake. And I just want to say, when we were planning, Drew said, "You have not lived life until you have eaten a raspberry cheese pie from Pancake Mill." So we bought several of those just in her honor. And so we're going to do a couple worship songs. You can join in. We'll have the words on the screen. Let's do that.
Let's put your hands together.
Praise the Lord. Prince of power, rough sin in darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger. The King of glory, the King above all kings, who shakes the whole earth with holy.
Be seated. Great. Well, I wanted to take just a moment. A lot of times the videos and the slides will introduce the next speaker, but what I wanted to do was introduce the next speaker. And the students are invested in this planning. Several of them met with me, a few through FaceTime or video, and a few on the phone and in person. And we just talked about the students and faculty and who do we have speak. And it's always a hard thing because they all have favorites, their teachers. But two stood out this year, and that was Mrs. Waddington and Miss Allred. And so we're going to hear from them. I think it's fitting that the seniors who are finishing and launching into their next season of life, Mrs. Waddington, after over 19 and a half years with Coquille High School, is coming to the close in her career. So would you welcome Mrs. Waddington? Yeah.
I don't see you guys smile either, but tonight I'm gonna smile. I brought this out of my office.
Be right up on the microphone.
I brought this out of my office. It says, chase your dreams. You guys haven't got to go in my office this year because of COVID, so I just wanted to bring that as a reminder. I wanted to thank you guys. Thank you for asking me to speak tonight. It's not my favorite thing. congratulations to the class of 2021 seniors. I'm very proud of you all for pushing through the COVID pandemic year and all of its ever-changing rules to finish as a 2021 graduate. It's definitely been a long and memorable year, and all of you have risen to the challenge. I am also a Coquille High School graduate, way back in the class of 1982. Yep, that's a long time ago. As I was reflecting back to that time, I remembered being a part of my baccalaureate. I was a verse reader that day, that long ago memory. So my short little presentation is gonna be some inspirational quotes. So here I go. Your work is going to fill a large part of your life. And the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, which most of you haven't, and you're gonna be working towards that, keep looking. Don't settle. As will all matters of the heart, you'll know when you find it. And that one was written by Steve Jobs. Life isn't about waiting for the storm to pass. It's about learning to dance in the rain. So hopefully we see a lot of dancing. If you see someone fall behind, walk beside them. If you see someone being ignored, find a way to include them. If someone has been knocked down, lift them up. Remind people of their worth. One small act can mean the world to them. Send the text. Make the phone call. Let go of the grudge. Forgive the person. Show more kindness. Tell them you love them and you've missed them. And don't take anyone for granted. Be kind to one another, even if you disagree. I think we see a lot of that in this world today. And the last one is, to make a difference in someone's life, you don't have to be brilliant, rich, beautiful, or perfect. You just have to care. Seniors, sometime this week, please make sure you give your parents or whomever raised you a hug and tell them thank you. Maybe even give them an I love you. I'm gonna leave it with a Bible verse that I love. It is more blessed to give than to receive. Acts 20:35. Good luck and best wishes, you guys. I wish you all the best.
For those of you who don't know me, I'm Catherine Allred, and I teach English at Coquille High School. When I was first asked to speak at the baccalaureate, I was both honored and horrified. I don't like public speaking, but this class, I'm gonna cry, is beyond special to me. Sorry. They were the first class that I taught all the way through. Sorry. And they're all dear to me. I knew I was gonna cry. Okay. And now we can't see my paper. I've always wanted to be a teacher. When I was little, I would come home and pretend to teach my imaginary class. I would teach the lessons I learned that day in school, and I even pretended to grade papers. I was an only child much of my life, and I had to do a lot of imaginative play and talking to myself. Yes, this is embarrassing to admit. As I got older, I didn't know what I wanted to do with my life. We moved to Oregon between my freshman and sophomore year, and it was very difficult being the new kid. I wasn't a very good student, and I hated going to school. My number one goal when I graduated was to go back to California. So when I graduated, the first thing I did was pack up my car and started driving south. On the way there, I got a phone call from my aunt, whom I was to live with, telling me that it was not a good idea to move in with her. So we turned around and drove home. All of my dreams and plans were crushed. I sat around all summer moping and angry that this dream life I was going to live in California just wasn't going to happen. Now, I'm not trying to make this all about me, but my point is that now looking back, I think the disappointment and defeat I experienced was actually a blessing in disguise. Sorry. Because it led to a life that I now lead and love. It led me to this moment right here. Sorry, guys. Okay. I want to tell the class of 2021 that there is one thing to know in life, and that is that every battle in your life won't last forever. There will always be a time of blessing and a time of disappointment or despair. So when you're in a blessing, enjoy it. And when you're in a battle, endure it, because it won't last forever. What I thought I was going to do with my life when I graduated high school is not where I ended up. I want each of you to know that it's okay to try new things, for plans to not happen the way you expected it to, or to ask for help when you need it. You do not have to have it all figured out. The best thing about life after graduation is that it's a time of discovery and finding out who you are and who you want to become. Some of you are going to be leaving your parents and living on your own and realizing that when you run out of toothpaste, you have to go to the store and buy it yourself now. This actually happened to me. This is the time when you get to write your own story and you are no longer defined by your past or your academic achievements. You get to go out in the world and discover what life has to offer. This year, I asked my students to research any topic they wished. One group came up with the question, what would you want to know if you were my age? So here it is, what I'd want someone to tell 18-year-old me. I'd say you are worth it. You don't need to prove anything to anyone except yourself. You don't need to mold yourself to be like anyone else or to do something because everyone else is doing it. I'd say to be a good friend and check in on other people even if they don't seem like they don't need it. The strong ones need to hear that they're cared about too. I'd tell you it's okay to take a break from the path you thought you'd go down. Don't get stuck in that rejection. Know that setbacks are okay and a time to reflect and make a new plan. I'd remind you to know your worth. Your value isn't defined by what others say about you, but what you say about yourself. So be kind to yourself. I tell you that perfection is an unreachable goal, although you should always try to do your best. I'd encourage you to set boundaries for yourself in all your relationships, school or work, friends and family. And I can't leave this group without trying to encourage all of you to read more. You can listen to audiobooks too. Every year, I give students time in class to silently read. I always remind them that I don't care what they're reading as long as it's something that interests them. Usually the kids moan and groan about this, but it always makes me laugh because when I don't have them anymore, the thing I hear the most is that they miss reading with me or miss hearing me read to them. But reading and learning about others' experiences helps us not feel so alone. These may be fictional characters that we read about, but they are real problems and experiences, and you can find comfort in knowing that you are not alone in your experience. There's a poetry book called 10 Things I Know to Be True, where writers create poems about things they know to be true. So I end this with telling you 10 things I know to be true. So 1, I know that hard things can be done. 2, I know that when something is worth it, you keep trying. 3, I know that if we focus on the light, no matter how small, the dark will not prevail. 4, I know that asking for help is not a sign of weakness, but a sign of strength. 5, I know that you are all capable of amazing things and that you are all loved. 6, I know that you only live once, so don't waste your time on worrying about things you can't control. 7, I know that finding people in your life who lift you up and make you laugh are essential. 8, I know that social media is a highlight reel and not a behind-the-scenes look at someone's life and real struggles. 9, I know that nothing good happens after 2 a.m. And the last thing I'll leave you with that I know to be true is it's my first year teaching, and I'm walking around the classroom, and a student said to me, Mrs. Allred, are you angry? And I said, no, why? And the student very seriously says, oh, so that's just your face. And in that moment, I knew I had chosen the right career. So congratulations to the class of 2021. I'm very proud of you.
Sunset bills on my mindset, I can't deny it. Getting higher, higher than my income. Income's breadcrumbs, I've been trying to survive. The glow that the sun gets right around sunset helps me to realize this is just a journey. Drop your worries, you are gonna turn out fine. Oh, you turn out fine. Fine, oh, you turn out fine. But you gotta keep your head up, oh, and you can let your head down, hey. You gotta keep your head up, oh, and you can let your head down, hey. I know it's hard, know it's hard to remember sometimes. But you gotta keep your head up, oh, and you can let your head down, hey, 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 hey. I got my hands in my pockets, kicking these rocks. It's kinda hard to watch this life go by. I'm buying into skeptics, skeptics mess with the confidence in my eyes. I'm seeing all the angles, thoughts get tangled, I start to compromise. My life and my purpose, is it all worth it? Am I gonna turn out fine? Oh, you turn out fine. Fine, oh, you turn out fine. But you gotta keep your head up, oh, and you can let your head down, hey. Your head up, oh, and you can let your head down, hey. I know it's hard to remember sometimes. But you gotta keep your head up, oh, and you can let your head down, hey, hey, hey. Only rainbows after rain, the sun will always come again. And it's a circle, circling around again. It comes around again. I said only rainbows after rain, the sun will
you wanna see and take you where you wanna be. You could be my luck. Even if the sky is falling down, I know that we'll be safe and sound.
Ooh, I could take my mask off now. Yeah. This is pretty cool. Alrighty. My name is Gia Faith. I'm a senior in the most awesome class that ever came out of Coquille. 2021, can we all clap for that? Okay. Just want to say thank you to all the parents and Sam, the church, and the band who put this all on. Like, those songs are rocking, definitely adding them to the playlist. I just wanna say, first of all, we did it. Like, we are currently living the last chapter of a very long novel.
But what they forgot to tell us was that the novel was only the first installment of a whole series. And I couldn't be more grateful to have lived through book one with all of you guys. Now, I have to tell you, these last 4 years, I have learned so much from each and every one of you, staff and students alike. And I want to share some of these lessons that I learned. And hopefully remind you guys of some things that should be included in your whole series. Number one, be patient. With everything that has happened in 2021 as a student, patient might as well be our middle names, let's be honest. And I hope you all continue to be patient because I've seen you guys become better people because of it. Number two, be skeptical and ask questions. Guys, we're branching out into the real world, where we no longer have to raise our hand and ask to be called on. Don't let opportunities pass you by because you guys were holding back. 4 years just flew by like a jet with an extra turbo engine. Imagine how the rest of our lives will go. Don't spend it waiting. Number three, your voice matters. No matter how loud or how quiet you say it, whatever is important to you guys matters. And don't stop until you find somebody who will listen. Because trust me, there's somebody out there who will listen. Unless you like pineapple on pizza, then I really just have to close my ears to that one, not gonna lie. Just kidding. I'll always listen, even if you like the worst pizza on the planet. Number four, ask for help. We come from a small community, and I couldn't be more grateful to have that. I know, personally, that I can always ask for help from back home, and I hope you guys are very aware of that, too. You can always call up our teachers, whether it's, hey, Mrs. Allred, I have a question, or hey, Ellie, what was that thing again? I know I can always call back to home for help. Number five, question authority. Now, don't get me wrong. This one was taught to me by actually one student, Kendall Hallmark. Not sure if he's here today. But what Kendall taught me was never to just sit back and be okay with just learning basic surface level information. Ask questions and don't stop until all your whys and hows have been answered. Never sit by and not understand or not have questions be cleared to you. Don't stop until that happens, and I want to thank Kendall for this. Now, I hope you guys really take all of these reminders to heart, because if they've already gotten us through 4 years of high school and at least 12 years of schooling, I don't think they'll fail us from here on out. Now, I wanted this speech to be more about the future, but can we just flip back a page and reflect on something real quick? Just want everybody to take a deep breath and think. We no longer have to lie to Mr. Cooper that our paper is almost done, just use his class as a free period, and then do the paper either the day or the hour before. I mean, stressful times, and I know most of us will continue to do it. Now, let's flip the page to the now. This is us. Every person today has accomplished something that many could not do, won't do, or never had the chance to do. We should be proud. You should be proud of yourselves, and people who helped us along the way should be proud of all of us. We're only a couple days of walking across that stage, and some of us will shake hands and hug each other for the last time after this week. Cherish these moments with each other and make memories while we're all still together as a whole. I really didn't know how to end this, so I decided to send you off with a quote by Kristen Bell. When you respect the idea that you are sharing the earth with other humans, and when you lead with your nice foot forward, you'll win every time. It might not be tomorrow, but it comes back to you when you need it. Now, I hope we all take that and just remember, be kind and be patient with one another. Thank you for letting me be a part of your stories, and I'm excited to see what you'll all write for yourselves from here on out. Thank you.
Don't worry. This is just a stage you're going through. This stage changes us. Children walk up to it, and proud men and women walk down. You'll be different tomorrow. You'll be different after you shake the hand and take the photo. You'll be different when you see your name on the paper. sitting idle. It does not entertain apathy. This stage is for going and growing, for moving and maturing and rising, for becoming and expanding and thriving. This stage runs, it does not walk. It pursues, it does not tarry. It transforms, it does not shrivel. It rewards, it does not withhold. It begins, and it does not end until you hear the words, "Well done." You'll turn the tassel. You'll throw your hat, and then you will shine. So go. Go and shine. Walk that stage and shine to the cheers. Walk that stage and shine back at your fears. Walk that stage and shine to the voices that said you couldn't do it. And walk that stage and shine to God who saw you through it. Because remember, it was only by His grace that you could do it. So walk that stage and claim your voice. Grab that mic, speak louder than the noise. Check, check one. We are waiting to hear what you have to say.
Hey, good night. Oh, hello, everybody. I want to thank Pastor Sam, Mayor Sam, Firefighter Sam, and all the rest that were involved in this to pull this thing off in such a short bit of time. And also, invite me to speak. And the cool thing is that if you're ready for the cheesecake or whatnot, I'm the last speaker. So, all right. Well, let's go ahead with that first slide, shall we? There are a lot of directions that we can go in life, and there's a lot of places we can end up. And, man, if there's anything I can do in the next few minutes, it might help you direct a path that's not going to end up here. Some of you that know me and you know my testimony, I wasn't quite there. But it was a rough side trip before God got a hold of me and made a difference in my life and got things together. And so that's not where you want to be, trust me. And I've only got maybe 8 or 9 minutes. And so, you know, Almighty God can say a whole lot more than I can in 8 or 9 minutes. So a lot of it is I'm just going to read scripture and comment. But before we do, go ahead and go on to the blank slide so this isn't distracting. No, just the blank slide. There should be one in between these two. That your last year and a half almost has been going through this whole COVID thing, right? And I don't know about you, but it's been hard for me. It's been hard for me because it's been difficult on relationships and seeing people and knowing if they're thriving and doing okay. And, you know, depression is up and anxiety is up. And you've been through this weird thing that really nobody else that's alive has ever been anything quite like you have. It's kind of like when I recently flew to Florida. And, you know, one of the things they say at the beginning when the stewardess does their little safety routine is they talk about in the unlikely event of maybe, you know, like an over-the-water evacuation or something. In the unlikely event, that's what this last year and a half has been. It's an unlikely event that comes on us, and then we have to do, you know, what we can to hopefully more than survive, to thrive. So on with what God has to say tonight. I want to talk particularly about what is new and different, okay, and what brings about change in life. And the next to last chapter in the whole Bible is Revelation chapter 21, where Jesus says, "Behold, I make all things new." I make all things new. God is all about newness. The very gospel is predicated on newness, change, transformation, life. Next slide. This is one of my, this is kind of one of my life verses, because it expresses what I'm trying to say. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all new things have, or all things have become new. For some of us, that is seriously good news. That we can come to a place where all that mess can now be in our past. And now it can be new and it can be good. All the way back in Isaiah, next slide. It says that, you know, forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. God's all about doing a new thing. And I know for some of you right now, I mean, graduating is a new thing. Going off to what comes after graduation is a new thing. What are you going to do with that? What direction are you going to take? And where are you going to end up? So, again, next slide. So walk in newness of life. This has to do with, you know, saying I confess my life to Christ and I'm gonna lay aside the old and I'm gonna take up the new. Walk in newness of life. And I believe it is this. If you've at least heard the word gospel, right? Whether it's gospel music or whether it's the gospel of salvation. But the simplest way I could express to you what is the gospel, what transforms and changes our lives, what took my life, is that Almighty Jesus, as Almighty God, not lesser than that, not some man who became God, not some visitor from another planet, not anything else, but Jesus as Almighty God died in my place, in your place, because we deserve that. And he died in our place, and he rose again from the dead, and he gives new life to those who believe. So walk in newness of life. You know, this is, as Sam said in the introduction, Pastor Sam, that this is a faith-based graduation. And so I want to speak to you that are here today. Some of you are here because you were thrilled to be here. You know, you're being able to see what is it that B cohort or the A cohort, you know, when you haven't been able to be together in the same place for quite some time. Others, I've kind of watched your body language a little bit, kind of like, you know, somebody may become. What direction are we going to take and where are we going to end up? It's kind of like this. Next slide. Metamorphosis. You know, most of us, we learned about that in science class. And it really is. I mean, a lot of things in life we take as, they're not really so miraculous because they happen all the time. But a tree with a tiny little seed falling in the ground and becoming a giant redwood or even just a maple in the back. I mean, that's crazy, but it just, because it happens all the time. A baby, right? With the whole conception thing and the tube and becoming one and then all the subdivision and going through the whole thing to where a baby is born and then they're you and me. I mean, that's kind of like natural, right? But only because it happens all the time. It's really supernatural. And the transformation that God can make in your life from behold, you know, all things have passed and now, you know, behold, all things are new. Is a miracle like metamorphosis. Next slide. It's kind of like the highest metamorphosis, taking us from that which is natural and just human to something that really becomes supernatural that God has embraced and God will embrace for eternity. A metamorphosis. Go on to the next blank slide. I just want to read a passage of scripture. As we come toward the closing, I alluded to it earlier in the first slide about all things new. A little bit bigger context in Revelation chapter 21. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is among men, and he will dwell among them, and they shall be his people, and God himself will be among them. And he will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there will no longer be death, there will no longer be any mourning or crying or pain. The first things have passed away. And he who sits on the throne," that's Jesus, "he who sits on the throne said, 'Behold, I am making all things new. And he said, write these words, for they are faithful and true. Then he said to me, it is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give to the one who thirsts, that's me right now, the spring of the water of life without cost. He who overcomes will inherit these things, and I will be his God, and they will be my people. That's what God says. I would hope that, you know, we can try to get through this life on our own. And I don't, quite honestly, I don't think any of us got what it takes to do that. I know none of us have what it takes to earn salvation and be with God forever. And so I would invite you to, you know, why not take the hand of the one who said he loves you. He proved it by dying for you. And he says, take my hand. You can take the hand of the creator of the universe. You can take the hand of the star breather, the one who speaks and the universe comes into being. Or we can try and make it on our own. Next slide. He who was seated on the throne said, behold, I'm making all things new. And he said, write this down, for these words are faithful, are trustworthy and true. Next slide, last slide. Behold, I'm making all things new. There's a lot of different paths that you can take. And there's a lot of different places you can end up. You were created by God to know God. You were created by him to be with him and walk with him and let him escort you both through life and to eternal life. So I was just about to pray, because I always end a little sermon with prayer. But I'm going to save that time, let somebody else pray. But God bless all of you. And as you go out into this new world, coming out of such a crazy context that you have spent the last year and a half of your lives, as often as I think of you, and I know some of you individually, but also as I think of you as a class, I will pray for you. God bless you. Thank you.
Hey, you did it. From kindergarten until now, muscling your way through every hard moment, climbing your way up all the mountains that looked too high, you've got a lot to be proud of. You were asked for some inner strength along the way and steady character in challenging circumstances. So here you are, leaving your senior year behind, at the edge of new beginnings, a step toward fulfilling new dreams. So as you go, keep a few things in mind. Don't let others get the best of you. You control your emotions, not other people. Life is about more than making money. It's about making memories. It's about making God famous. And don't forget to call your parents. They worry about you. And remember, you are a treasured life. God formed you out of dust for such a time as this. He lights a path for you and holds you in his hands. May you follow the path God has set before you. May doors be opened before you and roadblocks disappear. And may you always be reminded that nothing is impossible with God.
Okay, this is on. So, me and three other students have been chosen to read a passage of scripture, And I just realized this like today, because I got the email and I didn't read it because I'm lazy. So verse one is, I've always had a hard time with this word. Deuteronomy. See? I had a hard time with it. 31:6. So be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. For the Lord your God will personally go ahead of you, and he will neither fail you nor abandon you.
I luckily got Proverbs 3:5-6. Trust God from the bottom of your heart. Don't try to figure everything out on your own. Listen for God's voice in everything that you do, everywhere you go. He is the one that will keep you on track.
Strength to the powerless. Even youths will become weak and tired, and young men will fall in exhaustion. But those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They will soar high on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint.
Dalla lettera ai Romani. Vi esorto dunque, fratelli, per la misericordia di Dio, ad offrire i vostri corpi come sacrificio vivente, santo e gradito a Dio. E questo è il vostro culto spirituale. Non conformatevi alla mentalità di questo secolo, ma trasformatevi rinnovando la vostra mente, per poter discendere nella volontà di Dio ciò che è buono, a Lui gradito e perfetto.
Well, good evening. I want to thank you for all having me here. And I know what you're thinking as I look out over this crowd of hopeful eyes. Who are you? Who in the world is this guy? Not one of you know who I am. That's because I'm new here in town. I want to thank Sam for giving me the opportunity to come and share with you. And maybe if you weren't graduating and leaving, you might learn who I was. But many of you that stick around in town, maybe you'll bump into us here. We look forward to seeing you succeed in the things that you're going to do with your life, and we're just blessed to be a part of that. You know, I've heard a lot of people come up here today and say that they're nervous about standing up in front of a bunch of people. I just want you to know that I'm not, and I'm going to tell you a secret about pastors. We're egomaniacs, most of us, and we love attention, so we don't stand up here on the stage always just for simple and humble reasons. We just love attention, so those of you that got nervous,
what?
I'm sorry. But anyway, I have, in over 30 years of ministering to students, seen and spoken into the hearts and lives of, I'm going to say thousands of graduates. And in that time, you know, I've gotten to see kids get their, get the school that they wanted, their first choice, get in. And I've seen guys and girls that didn't get what they wanted, and some go right into the job market. Some graduate from college, and some have me do their weddings and all these different things. And I've seen all these life markers. And as I've seen students over 30 years do all those things, there's one thing I want to leave you with tonight as we get ready to close this up. It's those students who live the most happy and fulfilling lives are the ones that made Jesus the most important part of it, starting right where you are right now. And I know a lot of you are thinking to yourself, I'm going to have some fun in college, and then I'll get serious when I have a family later. That's one way to look at life, but I'm going to promise you, you're going to look at life later and realize I missed out on a whole bunch of amazing times in my life to be a servant of the King if I don't just make sure that I'm doing it now and continue to do it throughout. So, as we get ready to knock over this stand, as we get ready to say goodnight to you, would you seniors rise up again as we're going to say a blessing over you tonight? And then I think Sam's going to close us off and give us some instruction. All right, let's pray. Lord, you are amazing, you are powerful, and you are the King of all. And many years ago, 18 or so years ago, you knit these students together in their mother's wombs, and you prepared for them a place. And God, you have a path that's set out for them. And we pray tonight that the thing that we're thinking about above all things isn't just that what are my plans for the next few years, but what are my plans for eternity? Because God, you have set something in motion for each one of us. And we just have to be willing to step up and take hold of that mantle and say, we are going to be Christ followers for the rest of our lives. No matter what our vocation is, no matter who we end up marrying, Lord, we are going to chase after you with everything we are. God, we thank you for the blessing of bringing this group of students together and for the successes that you brought them through. And Lord, we just praise you for the great future that you have in store for them. It's in his name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Seniors, remain standing. It's okay. Can we appreciate the seniors one more time? Let's do that. Yes. All right. So a little bit of instruction. We're getting ready to close. And I forgot to mention the restrooms are in the middle of the hallway. If you need restrooms, what we're going to do is there's like six different cheesecakes on the table back there. There's decaf, coffee, water. There's drinks there. We want you to know that in this sanctuary, we have a great time, and it changes all the time. So these chairs can literally be turned, moved into circles, and so when you get your desserts, you can just sit and eat and visit, and you have to take your mask off to eat, and so just, you know, you can be as cautious as you need to be or want to be, but enjoy. In just a moment, we'll kick in some music as well, and we just want you to have a great time. Thank you, seniors, for coming out and allowing us to just bless you and launch you. Congratulations, and looking forward to graduation this Sunday. So, seniors, you get to go first. Let's go. Go ahead, seniors. Oh, real quick, seniors, we have a gift for you as well. They're going to give them to you. If you have friends who couldn't make it tonight and you want to take extra ones for your friends, please ask for that. They'll make sure you get them, okay? And we have gifts for you as well. Let's start on that end of the table where the silverware is. And once the seniors are through, families, we get to go next.